Hi, I'm Norbi Babos, the technical manager at SolarKit. In this video, I'll walk you through the equipment and components of our small demo site, detailing their specifications, unique features, and the best applications for each of them. So, before we dive into the details, make sure to subscribe to our channel using the button below to stay updated on our latest videos. Don't forget to click the bell icon as well. That way, you'll receive notifications every time we upload something new. What you see here next to me is the Sun 5000 8K MAP0 inverter. This is part of a newly introduced series of inverters, designed specifically for systems where every single solar panel must be equipped with its own optimizer to ensure proper installation and operation. This means we cannot partially optimize the system or skip adding an optimizer altogether. Each and every panel must have its own optimizer installed to ensure proper functionality. The manufacturer highlights this feature with a special badge, indicating that this is a unique and advanced type of inverter. One major benefit of fully optimizing every panel is the improved safety features. For instance, when you install the Merck Sun 600 series, you'll see the Safe Roof badge, which reflects its focus on safety. These inverters, combined with optimizers, can monitor the temperature of each optimizer's MC4 connector. If the temperature exceeds a specific threshold, the system automatically shuts down the DC side to prevent overheating. This feature significantly reduces the risk of an overheating connector leading to a fire on the roof, ensuring a much safer installation and operation. This is a feature that has been introduced specifically because of the full optimization requirement. Another new capability of this inverter is its ability to handle asymmetry. You can find a detailed explanation of this in our commissioning video, where we demonstrate how the inverter manages asymmetry and how you can effectively use it in both on-grid and off-grid modes. This inverter is very similar to the M1 series in its overall design and functionality. It features two MPPTs, each connected to its own string, a dedicated battery input, a communication port, and an AC connection that enables seamless and reliable integration with the grid. To operate this inverter in off-grid mode, an additional external device is required. This smart guard allows for smooth and automatic switching between on-grid and off-grid modes, ensuring consistent, reliable, and uninterrupted operation in all scenarios. Let's open it up and take a closer look at its internal components and capabilities. To open it, you'll need the factory key that unlocks it from the side. Let's remove this plastic cover, which can be done using a standard crosshead screwdriver. It's secured by just a single screw. Inside, starting from left to right, you'll find two connection options for inverters, one rated at 63 amps and the other at 32 amps. The user manual specifies which inverter models are compatible with each port. It's worth noting that the smart guard is compatible with existing M1 and M5 hybrid inverters. Naturally, it includes the functionality of the old backup box. For instance, if you're using an M1 or M5 symmetric inverter, you'll still be able to run a single phase on the backup side without any issues. However, this has been further improved with the new smart guard system. If you're using an asymmetric inverter, you need to connect it specifically to the 63 amp breaker located at the bottom. The upper section of the device is fully pre-wired, so you won't need to handle any connections there. All you have to do is carefully connect the required cables to the terminals at the bottom to complete the setup. So here we have two specific circuit breakers that are responsible for connecting the inverters properly. The overall concept behind the smart guard system is designed in such a way that it needs to be installed between the power line coming from the electric meter and the home's distribution board. Essentially, this means that the main power cable running through the entire house must pass directly through the smart guard. This setup ensures seamless integration and control. To support this, the smart guard comes pre-equipped with an EMA meter, which is a flow-through energy meter specifically designed for monitoring energy transfer. Among the two-pole circuit breakers, The one on the left is the one responsible for receiving energy from the grid. To complete the connection, the cable coming from the electric meter must be securely wired to the lower terminal of this breaker to establish a proper and safe grid connection. The circuit breaker on the right is dedicated to the backup side, which will always remain powered. This means there won't be a power outage as long as the solar panels are producing energy or there is stored power in the battery. Right next to it, there's a terminal block designed for connecting consumer devices that operate in on-grid mode. These devices will continue to receive power as long as the electrical grid is operational and there is no disruption or outage in the power supply. The entire house, the entire property, is connected to the backup side. This means that if the power supply from the utility company is interrupted, the whole house can continue to use electricity without any interruptions, provided by the energy generated by the solar system. Now, to make this setup work, we need a specific wiring configuration that includes an inverter, the grid connection, and the backup side for uninterrupted power supply. Here we have a particularly important cable that incorporates five wires on both ends. Three phases, a ground, and a neutral conductor. On the inverter side, the three phases and the neutral are connected securely to the circuit breaker to establish a stable connection. At the rear of the smart guard, there is a dedicated ground bar where you can attach both the ground wire from the inverter and the one originating from the grid. However, the ground wire running toward the house, which is more accurately referred to as the protective earth conductor, must not be connected to the ground bar. Instead, it should be routed directly to the pen terminal to maintain safety and system integrity. This is an essential detail. When wiring the backup cable to the house, the green and yellow protective earth conductor must always be connected to the terminal rather than the ground bar to ensure everything functions correctly. In this setup, the primary power supply flows directly from the grid into the MA meter, which acts as the entry point for the system. From there, it seamlessly routes through the EMA and continues onto the EPS side, providing reliable and uninterrupted operation for the system and connected devices. One feature we haven't discussed yet is this small circuit breaker located next to the EMA meter. It contains a half fuse that acts as a critical backup safety switch. Its purpose is to provide a direct connection to the grid in case of a failure in the inverter, the battery, or the EMA itself. If the system can no longer deliver proper control to transfer energy from the grid to the house, this breaker allows you to bypass the system and connect the grid directly to the consumers. Essentially, if you remove the small safety pin and flip the breaker, the system will supply power to the house regardless of what's happening behind it. It doesn't matter if the system is working, not working, or what mode it's in. Once you switch it on, it will operate independently. The system will instantly redirect energy from the grid to the house, ensuring that power is always supplied from the grid in any situation. When you activate the small bypass switch, as explained in the user manual, the system will immediately recognize it. If the system is operational, it will generate an error message indicating that the bypass switch is engaged. In this mode, the inverter's functionality becomes slightly restricted because it cannot fully determine the current operating state. During this time, the battery will step in to supply power, maintaining operation while the bypass mode is active. When it comes to communication wiring, everything inside the smart guard is already pre-connected. Our task is simply to connect four wires as specified in the user manual. The EMA is pre-configured, and there is a 12-pin terminal block provided, from which we use the first four wires to establish the connection to the inverter. By completing this setup, the entire communication system within the smart guard is fully configured and ready for seamless operation. Another feature is the ability to connect the EMA to the internet via an Ethernet cable instead of Wi-Fi. If you prefer a wired setup, you can route the Ethernet cable through the slots at the bottom of the smart guard and plug it into the RJ45 ports provided underneath. This ensures a stable and reliable connection for the system. As you can see right now, the system is functioning properly with adequate lighting and smooth operation. I'm connected via my phone, allowing us to monitor its status. We can also test to simulate what would happen in a power outage, giving us a clear understanding of the system's response. We won't cut the power directly at the meter, but it's incredibly helpful to have breakers here to safely simulate a grid power outage. By switching off the breaker that connects the smart guard to the grid, we can effectively replicate a loss of power supply. As a result, the smart guard and all connected appliances will immediately stop receiving power from the grid. Within the smart guard settings, there's a specific feature called seamless switchover, which ensures a smooth and uninterrupted transition to off-grid mode during such unexpected events. Now, as we can see on the display, the inverter shows grid connected and power limited, indicating that this is a system with export limitation, meaning it doesn't feed power back to the grid. Currently, we're drawing 14 watts from the grid. If we now simulate a scenario where the power supply from the meter is interrupted, or in other words, the grid connection is lost, what exactly will happen inside the house? Let's test it out by flipping the switch. As you can see, nothing really happens. We still have lights, the smart guard is running, and the app switches seamlessly to indicate we're now in off-grid mode. The whole point of this setup is that you don't even notice when there's a grid outage. While operating in off-grid mode, you can continue using your household appliances without any interruptions, just as if everything were running normally. The application clearly shows off-grid operation, indicating that the system is primarily drawing energy directly from the solar panels. If additional power is required, it will automatically supplement it from the battery. Right now, the household is consuming roughly 970 watts of energy, which is being supplied simultaneously by the solar panels and the battery. In this mode, the system operates entirely independently from the grid, ensuring that the household remains powered without any reliance on external electricity supply. There's a small LED indicator here which you wouldn't be able to see anyway if the smart guard's cover is closed. In fact, it's not visible at all when the cover is shut. However, it has now turned orange, indicating that the system is operating in off-grid mode. In this state, you can fully utilize the inverter's capacity and the battery as long as there's energy stored in it. If the battery runs out, whether at night or during times with no sunlight, the house will unfortunately experience a complete blackout due to the lack of available power supply. However, if the battery runs out during the day for any reason, or if it's disconnected due to a malfunction but the solar panels are still generating power, the house can continue to operate solely on the energy produced by the PV system. This will work as long as the household's energy consumption remains lower than the output of the solar panels. If we simulate the return of grid power, reconnecting it by flipping the breaker back on will restore the supply. In this case, nothing noticeably changes. The inverter continues to generate power as it normally would without interruption. Within about a minute, the smart guard will automatically switch back to on-grid mode, and the small LED light inside will turn green, clearly indicating that the system has reconnected to the grid. At the moment, we are operating entirely in off-grid mode, and as you can see behind me, the AC and DC LED lights on the inverter are glowing orange. This signifies that the system is functioning completely independently from the grid, with no energy being fed back into it and no grid input currently available to the system. When the system switches back to on-grid mode, the EMMA sends a signal to confirm the transition. You might hear a distinct clicking sound from the EMMA, indicating it has engaged. Once the LED turns green again, it confirms that the system has reconnected to the grid and the power supply has been restored. By checking the inverter, you can verify the status using the LEDs, which will show whether the system is connected to the grid or disconnected due to a lack of input or another issue preventing grid supply. These two LEDs are important, and it's crucial to note they are orange, not red. A red LED indicates an error, signaling an issue with the system. When both the DC and AC LEDs are orange, it shows the system is operating in off-grid mode. And, of course, the same applies when switching from on-grid to off-grid mode. The LEDs will turn orange as soon as the AC side disconnects, and they'll remain orange until grid power is restored and the system starts feeding into the grid again. Now, one last device we haven't discussed yet on our demo site is the E1 battery. Compared to its predecessor, it offers a capacity of 7 kWh per module, So what you see here assembled amounts to 14 kilowatt hour. The biggest difference, aside from its capacity, is the power output capability of each module. Each module supports charging and discharging at half a C rate, which means 3.5 kilowatt per module. Combined, that's 7 kilowatt of power output for the two modules. If you add a third module, the total capacity increases to 21 kilowatt hour, and the power output capability rises to 10.5 kilowatt. This is a significant improvement compared to the previous S0 series battery, which supported only 5 kilowatt hour. Compared to the previous S0 battery, which only had a capacity of 5 kilowatts, this represents a substantial improvement overall. Another notable aspect, particularly from an installation perspective, is that there are no external connectors on this battery. Everything is housed internally, which means the modules only need to be stacked on top of each other. As they are stacked, the connectors automatically link together, eliminating the need to prepare or manually connect separate cables. The only connections you need to make are on the left side, where you connect the DC positive and negative grounding and communication cables to the inverter. This is one of its unique features. Additionally, on the right side, there's a rotary switch that allows you to turn the battery on or off. Next to the rotary switch, you'll find a small black start button, which can be used to manually start the battery if it's completely discharged or fails to start on its own. Along with these features, the assembly process is very quick and efficient, since all you have to do is stack the modules on top of each other. The side panels are also relatively easier to assemble compared to earlier models. They simply need to be slid down smoothly from the top, and each side requires just a single screw for attachment. This is a significant improvement over the previous design, where each individual panel required a separate screw for securing. As you can see, the display has been slightly updated. While the arrangement of the LEDs remains almost completely similar, there's a charge level indicator made up of 10 small LEDs, with each representing exactly 10% of the battery's total capacity. At the moment, it shows that the battery is between 90% and 100% charged. The indicators show the battery's charge level, and as the charge decreases, they gradually turn off one by one. There's also a small design element around them that flashes during charging or discharging, providing a visual cue. On the left side, a communication light helps confirm the system's status. If you see it flashing, showing the charging status and capacity, it means everything is working properly. However, if any indicator turns red, it signals an issue that requires attention. One important thing to mention is that, just like the earlier S0 version, this model is also fully suitable for outdoor installation, being capable of operating efficiently in temperatures as low as minus 20 degrees Celsius. It includes a small integrated heating element, a film heater, specifically designed to prevent the battery cells from freezing in sub-zero conditions and to ensure that their temperature remains stable above zero. If you're interested in seeing how to install the inverter properly, you can watch the process in this video. If you're looking for the more advanced and technical settings of the inverter, such as those related to export limitation or less common usage scenarios, you can find detailed instructions in this video. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel below. Bye!